This is an HQ-170, and I am demonstrating it with the case off because I wanted to take a picture of the bottom and put the case on a little bit later. This is 160 meters that you're listening to, and apparently there's a contest going on, and this is kind of sad that that someone is on a nice Friday evening when they can be sitting down with his family and maybe watching TV or having a dinner. He's sitting in a little room calling CQ Contest. But let's tune across the band and see what we hear.
Yeah,
great. 160 meters. There's an N4 calling CQ, and we can use the selectivity to knock out the QRM, but there isn't any QRM right now, so we can't see how effective that is. There's more of the contest signal. So that's 160 meters. We'll try 75 meters next. This is 75 meters. There's certainly a lot of people on. That sounds like JT65. At least I thought it sounded like it for a second. For those of you who are new to ham radio, that's known as CW. And that is Morse code for 73. He said GL, and that's good luck. And it's a W3 that's calling. That's a CQ. And that's an N3. So let's go up a little higher in the band. We'll get some voice for those of you that are new to ham radio, don't understand Morse code. He's not in Mexico. That's a phonetic for those of you that are new to ham radio. And that's a contest. I'm trying to tune one person in here. There's a person that likes to yell into the mic. Let's see if we can find some AM here. Any AM? There.
N1BCG.
There's some AM.
We're starting training on the next course here, which is Canine Good Citizen Advanced, which is actually an entry-level therapy dog certification.
So we've listened to sideband, we've listened to AM, we've listened to CW, so you can see that it does work. I'm not sure how much it's been used lately, so maybe a little more spraying of contact cleaner might help at some point. But it looks pretty clean. Okay, we're going to try 40 meters. And see how that works out, 40 meters. And there's a contest there too. And there's a Canadian that has nothing better to do with his meaningless little life. Here's a guy, Norwing 3-4 India. And here's a K0. Well, there's a lot of stations on the band today. Well, let's go down into the CW section. Well, there's a lot of stations on here. Let's see if we can find some CW. Let's see if the selectivity works. We can knock out one of those stations. We don't have work bands on here because they didn't have work bands when this came out. Here's a CQ. He has a pretty decent fist. For those of you that are new to ham radio, a fist is how well you send a Morse code. There's that N9 again. Anyway, that's 40 meters. Now there's 20 meters. Let's go to upper sideband. And there's a contest there too. And what is it? Doesn't anybody have a life? Let's see what else we hear. I'm only using a dipole. K9CP, you're 598, whatever that means. Everybody's 5'9", amazingly. So that's 20 meters. I don't know if I can demonstrate 15 or 10. It doesn't open very much anymore. All right, let's look at the CW section, see if we hear any. That's a PSK. That was not invented yet when this came out. See if we can hear any CW down here. Yeah, CW requires a little bit of skill, so most of the contesters are on sideband. So I don't hear any CW. I don't hear any CW, not at all. Nothing. Not one station. One station. Very weak. Okay, let's try 15 meters and to see how that works. That sounds like some real DX. That doesn't sound like DX. Here's a Puerto Rican station.
Radio, 5905.
Let's take a look at the CW section. Don't hear anybody in the CW. Yeah. Okay, this is 10 meters. You can see. Let's see where he is. He keeps. Okay, so that's 10 meters right there. I'm not sure what the stability is on 10 meters. Seems I have to retune him a couple of times here.
Alpha India 1 Yankee 599.
But looks like 10 meters is open.
The 1 Yankee again.